Beetle Scruffs, you are invading my dreams, and I'm not sure how I feel about it.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, feeling you holding me tight, tight, yeah. It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find
days ago, some of you may recall a posting that I made on our Facebook page about how I had this dream and the Beetle Scruffs were in it, and it was about Paul. And I don't know why I had this particular dream, and I don't know what caused it, but all of us somehow ended up in the same place at once for this, like, Beetle exhibit thing at some place, which is strange in and of itself, because how would all of us get in one place when we live, like, not near each other? And this Beatles thing they had was some, like, Paul McCartney concert experience, where it was like you stood on this like a ledge thing, and it turned you upside down, so you were, like, staring at this ledge, which ended up being a screen. And I don't even know how to describe this, but on the screen would be Paul at his concert, and it, like, pulled back, like, you know, those rides at, like, Cedar Point where it, like, brings you up to the top and then, like, shoots you down. It was like that, except, like, Paul, he looked like he was up, like, really high above you, and then he just, like, shot down into your face. I don't know, it was so bizarre. But apparently the Beatles Scruffs got to be the first people to do that or something. And it was weird and yet kind of cool, because it's like, Paul in your face! So, yeah, I should get on creating that. Speaking of Paul, he was on Saturday Night Live last night, and I fell asleep like the lame person I am before I could watch it. So I found a link on Hulu of the whole episode from last night, and it's gonna be online for like the next 2.5 weeks or something. And it's kind of awesome. Pretty sure my favorite part was when Paul appears in the Stumbling sketch with Paul Rudd and Andy Samberg. it's hilarious, and it's, like, ridiculous and absurd, and you should watch it for yourself. He did, for the musical numbers, he did Jet and Band on the Run, and it was pretty cool. And he was in a couple of the sketches. He was in the Stumbling sketch and Weekend Update. He was providing an audio caption for a picture of Charles and Camilla. I don't know. I've only watched, like, bits and pieces. I haven't watched the whole way through yet. But, yeah, if you have, like, an hour to kill, can watch that, or you can just skip to the good parts. I don't know if Hulu is still only for the US. I don't know if you can, like, watch it in other countries, but if you can't and somebody who's in not the United States can find a link to it so everybody can watch, that'd be pretty cool too. Yeah. What else? What else? I don't know. Like, the main thing I wanted to talk about was this weird Paul dream. And, like, I never remember my dreams anyway, so I had to, like, consciously, like, think to myself to remember this dream, because you have to talk about it in your video. So, yeah. And the dream was weird because, like, I knew everybody was there, but, like, I only remember Carly and Sabrina being there. But everybody else was. Apparently, my dream didn't think it was important to include everyone. So, I don't know. Have anybody else had any, like, weird Beatle-related dreams? Like, I know the Beatles have appeared in my dreams before. I don't remember any of them. But if you have any of those experiences, tell me in the comments. And, yeah. Or if you have had any weird dreams of Paul concert experiences where he falls on your face as you're upside down on watching a giant screen. I can't possibly be the only one this has happened to. Okay, yeah. I'm gonna go watch the rest of Saturday Night Live now. So you should too. And I'll see you crazy kids next weekend. Bye.